What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about installing OpenSSL on Windows. So let's get right into it. All right, so I'm doing everything within a Windows 11 environment, but you could do the same thing within Windows 10. Now open up your favorite browser, and we're going to go into the following link and hit enter. It's going to take you here. I'm going to click on the OpenSSL 1.0.2J. Click on that. It's going to take you here and click on that zip file. It's going to take you to this page. It's going to start downloading, and it's about 3.8 megabytes. Wait until it finished downloading. We're going to click on the folder to open up our downloads folder. We're going to select it, right click on it, and we're going to pick extract all. You're going to get this, click on extract. It's going to start extracting all that information into the downloads folder. And once it's done, it's going to open up like this. Awesome. So we're going to select that OpenSSL folder, right click on it, and we're going to click on the scissors, like little scissors, which is the cut, and we're going to cut it. Now open up the File Explorer, and I'm going to go inside the C drive and right click inside the C drive, and then click on paste to paste that OpenSSL folder in there. Now on your left-hand side, we are going to right-click on Disk PC and then go into Properties. Within Properties, we're going to click on Advanced System Settings. And then within here, we're going to locate Environment Variables. Just click on that. Now within this dialog box, Users Variables for BTNHD or whatever your name is, we're going to select on Path. And we're going to click on edit. Now within here, we're going to click on the second row and we're going to type in the following, which is basically the path of our OpenSSL folder. Also inside that folder, we're going to call out the bin folder and just click on OK. Now we need to create our system variable. So click on new and the variable name is going to be the following. And for the variable value, we're going to call out this particular path. It's going to point to the OpenSSL.cnf file. Click OK, click OK, click OK on the system properties, and let's close this up. Now, next thing that we need to do is basically click on the start menu, click on the power button, and restart your machine, right? Just restart it. Once it restarts and you're here, we're going to right click on the start button. We're going to open up our terminal as an admin. Click yes on the user account control. And the first command that we're going to run is the following. We want to see if everything is working. Once you hit enter and something shoots out, this basically means that you have installed the OpenSSL successfully. Awesome. So let's say you want to use the OpenSSL utility within your Windows box to generate a private key. We need to enter the following command, which is this, and let's hit enter. Now it wants you to enter a password. So enter a password, confirm the password, and you're done. Now this particular private key was dropped into my user profile. So if you open up your user profile, you're going to see your private key. Now, let's say you want to take this private key and create a CSR, right? A CSR, right? Yeah, got it. The following command that we need to use using our OpenSSL utility would be the following. We're going to call out and use our private key. It's going to shoot out a CSR. Hit enter. You're going to enter your password for your private key. And once you're done, you need to enter some information for your CSR. We need to enter your country name, your state, the city, your organization name, organization and units, a common name or the full qualified domain name, your email address. You need to enter a challenge password. If you want, you're able to enter your company's name and you're done. Now go back inside your user profile and you're going to see your CSR file. So let's say we want to take the private key, the CSR, to generate a self-signed certificate. Super easy using OpenSSL utility. So we need to enter the following command. Pretty simple, right? Again, you're using your private key. It's using the CSR, and you're requesting a 365-day, which is a yearly self-signed certificate, and whatever name you provide. Hit enter. You're going to enter your password for your private key. Once you enter your private key password, hit enter, and you're done. Now go back inside your user profile and you're going to see your self-signed certificate. Double click on it and you're going to see, bam, right there. How awesome is that? And that's it, guys. That is how we install OpenSSL as well as generate a private key, a CSR, and also a self-signed certificate using that particular utility. Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.